When we first started talking about it, there was a lot of confusion about whether we could do it. A lot of worry about, well, is this possible?
It's a first of its kind in the ice industry, most certainly.
We're about to do something that's never been done before. We're testing our Motomaster Eliminator battery. We've frozen our battery to minus 40 degrees Celsius and really put it to the test. We thought, what better way to do it than a truck made out of ice?
I've lived here my whole life, and it's a good way to test life in Canada. This project right here was a bit of a challenge. They wanted to put 14,000 pounds of ice on a regular truck frame. This particular one had to be welded rigid because if it moves even a fraction of an inch, it'll crack the ice.
So we searched far and wide actually to find a truck that wasn't rusty, a suitable candidate, brought it into our shop, removed the body off of it, and prepared it to run under its own power.
Because this has never been built before and nobody's even come close to doing something like this, we wanted to make sure that there was enough coolant in the engine so that it didn't melt the ice.
Unlike your ice cubes at home, which might have a white center, which is actually air trapped inside, we remove all that air, so our blocks are crystal clear. And we did some testing and drove it over various pothole-filled roads to see how that frame and the ice on the frame fared.
We're taking the Canadian Tire ice truck and we're going to attempt to drive it 1.5 kilometers through the streets of Hensel to set a world's record. We wanted to create that kind of wintry environment and start that truck.
It was very neat to prove to everyone that we could do what we set out to do.
They're trying to make the cold not only a challenge for their own products, but they're also making it more fun.
To have a frozen truck that'll actually start and run down the road, that's part of Canada.